Hello everyone, I Kanchan Suresh Shete. First of all, I welcome you all my dear students of SYBCOM on this lecture of Business Communication 1 of Semester 3. Today we are going to start and learn the first chapter of Business Communication, that is Introduction of Business Communication. Friends, in the earlier session we have discussed the objectives and introduction of syllabus of this course, as well as we have seen the references which we will refer to acquire the knowledge of business communication, and we have also understand the guidelines for completion of practical of this subject. Now in this lecture we are going to study the introduction of business communication. After that we will study the meaning and definitions of business communication. Then we will see the process of business communication. After that we will study the characteristics of business communication, and lastly we will study the importance of business communication. Dear students, from this session you will get the knowledge of business communication and you can develop your good communication skills. Now let's start with the basic. Communication is a vital or important and inseparable part of every human being, that it contributes heavily to the success or failure of every human activity. We know people can't live alone. This universal truth signifies that people must have the companion, and one of the main reasons for having a companion is that people want to express themselves, and whenever we express something to someone, it is called as communication. That is why it is necessary to all the students of SYBCOM that to learn or to acquire the knowledge of business communication for your career opportunities. So let's see the brief introduction of business communication. Friends, the term business communication is made of two words, that is business plus communication. It means all those human activities which are performed for making profits. So it can be said that the business communication is that part of communication which is related to the business activities and help to the business dynamic. So the business communication may be defined as the passing of information, message or news within or outside the company. It is essential and it is goal oriented for success and growth of the company. Effective and efficient communication system helps in building goodwill of company, and it also helps managers to perform their jobs, responsibilities and functions of management like planning, organizing, leading and controlling, etc. So we can say that the communication acts as a lifeblood or organizational blood of business. No business can develop in the absence of effective communication system. Now let's see the actual meaning of business communication. Students, the word communication has been derived from the Latin word communis or communicare, which means to make common, to share or to participate. Hence, communication is a process of exchange or transmission of facts, ideas, opinion and feeling from one person to another person, and to create better understanding and harmonious relations among individuals or organizations. Communication adds meaning to human life and it enriches our knowledge of the universe and makes living worthwhile. Let's understand the definitions. So the first definition is according to W.H. Newman and C.F. Summer. As I said earlier, communication is an exchange of facts, ideas, opinions or emotions by two or more persons. Second definition of American Management Association defines communication is any behavior that results in an exchange of meaning. In simple words, according to Keith Davies, the process of passing the information and understanding from one person to another person. Let's see the process of business communication. There are mainly 7 elements of communication are given in the following diagram. So the first element of process of communication is sender. The communication process starts with the sender person who wants to transmit or exchange the message or his ideas, facts, opinions or emotions to another person. Sender is also called as a speaker, an actor or a writer or a transmitter of message. He may transfer, spread or communicate the message. Second element is message. A message means what is being communicated. It is the subject matter of communication. It may involve any fact, idea, opinion, feelings, including information. It may be written or oral and it should be proper, specific and accurate. Third element of process of communication is encoding. The process of conversion of ideas or subject matter into signs, symbols, words, actions and pictures is called as encoding. The sender converts his ideas or facts into words, signs or symbols which the other person can understand. Then fourth element is channel. It means the medium through which the message passes. A message can be conveyed by telephone, computer, letter, report and face-to-face exchange and audio-visual, etc. Then next comes is receiver. Receiver is also known as addressee or audience. Communication process is not completed without the existence of a receiver of the message. He receives the message and tries to understand and act upon it. Then sixth element is decoding. It is exactly opposite of the process of encoding. Decoding is a process under which receiver translates the words and symbols into his own ideas or facts. It means he receives, interpret and understand the signs and symbols which are intended by the sender. Then last element of process of communication is feedback. After receiving the message, the receiver sends back his response or reply to the sender. It is called as feedback. It is the key element of communication process. It is the result of critical assessment by the receiver. It may include suggestion, opinion. It helps the sender to know whether there should be any changes or correction in the message. Now we are going to understand the characteristics of communication. Let me explain it one by one. So the first characteristic is existence of two parties. Communication involves at least two parties, that is a sender and a receiver. The sender or communicator wants to speak, write or issue some instructions, and on the other hand the receiver receive and listen the message. Second characteristic is two-way process. Communication is essentially a two-way process and is not completed unless the receiver understands the message properly and sends back his response to the sender. For example, Mr. Y delivers a lecture in Hindi. Two Americans who do not understand Hindi, the communication process will be failed. Then next comes is continuous process. Communication is a continuous process. When communication is absent, human activity is unable to exist. Then fourth characteristic is existence of message. Communication involves some messages to be sent by the sender to the person or receiver. The message may be a thought, information, speech, advice, suggestions or opinions, etc. Next is communication may be verbal or non-verbal. Communication may be written or in gestural mean depending upon the need of the message. We can communicate through signs, symbols, facial expression or through letters, speech, etc. Then next characteristic is communication always exists or it is unavoidable. So the friend, communication is unavoidable and it is an inseparable part of human life. Humans intentionally or unintentionally keep communicating even without the use of word. Next characteristic is universal process. Communication is a universal process and it is essential in all types of organization and at all level of management. Next is mode of creating human relationship. It creates mutual understanding by giving information. Business organization can create and develop relationship with the help of communication. And last characteristic is goal-oriented process. Communication is a goal-oriented process. It can be effective only when the sender and receiver both are aware of the goal of communication. Now let's understand the importance of communication. Friends, competition and specialization in production functions have increased the importance of communication in a business. Without effective communication, managers cannot plan, organize, direct and control, as well as organization also cannot perform well. So the importance of communication for business is, as I earlier said, that it is the flow of lifeblood for the business as well as human beings. See, the first importance of communication is helpful in building relations. Communication is a two-way process which promotes cooperation and mutual understanding among the people of an organization. Through effective communication, the manager can convey his expectation to workers and workers can put their suggestion and problems before the manager. So an efficient communication system builds human relations. Next importance is help in motivation and leadership. Management can motivate and lead employees through communication only. Next importance is prompt decision making and its implementation. Communication helps the decision maker or managers to get the feedback and make the changes. Decision making and its implementation requires an effective communication system. Fourth one is effective control. Communication helps in controlling the activities of the workers. The management judge the performance of his subordinates and take remedial actions on the basis of feedback information from workers. Next importance is training and development. Communication provides knowledge for training and development of both workers and executives. Sixth importance is smooth working of a business firm. Communication is necessary for the successful smooth working of an enterprise. If the messages are not flowing freely across the organization, smooth, healthy working is not possible. Next is helpful in coordination. The modern complex organizations are large in size, having a large number of people working in the organization. To achieve common goals and desired objectives, it is necessary to coordinate the efforts of laborers engaged in the various activities. नेक्स्ट इम्पॉर्टेंस इज बेसिक ऑफ मैनेजरियल फंक्शंस. कम्युनिकेशन प्लेज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन डिस्चार्जिंग द वेरियस फंक्शंस ऑफ मैनेजमेंट. विद द प्रोसेस ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन मैनेजमेंट इशू द ऑर्डर्स कन्वे द डिसीजंस टू द एम्प्लॉय. नेक्स्ट इज कॉन्टैक्ट्स विद एक्सटर्नल पार्टीज. कम्युनिकेशन इज इसेंशियल नॉट ओनली फॉर इंटरनल मैनेजमेंट ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बट ऑल्सो हेल्प्स इन मेंटेनिंग गुड रिलेशंस विद द आउटसाइड वर्ल्ड. एंड लास्ट इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन इज जॉब सेटिस्फैक्शन. कम्युनिकेशन प्लेज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन इंस्पायरिंग पीपल टू वर्क हार्ड. मैनेजर्स कैन इंक्रीज द सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस एंड जॉब सेटिस्फैक्शन ऑफ एम्प्लॉयज बाई कीपिंग इन क्लोज टच. So we can say that the first executive function of organization is to develop and maintain a system of effective communication. Friends, here we are going to stop this session for today. We can conclude this lecture as we can say that communication is a vital element for the every existence of the organization, and organization is held together by communication. It enables the members to coordinate, to exchange and to progress. Hence, the communication where the exchange of ideas, information or facts between two or more persons take place in a business environment. In the next lecture, we will discuss the principles of communication, barriers to communication and remedies to overcome the barriers to communication. Thank you.